Hi everybody, welcome to today's session of ICSE Physics, keeping intellectually engaged. Today we are going to study an important concept called center of gravity. Consider the following observations. A porter while carrying a heavy load on his back has to lean forward. When you carry a heavy suitcase in your right hand, you have to lean towards the left in order to keep your balance. When you carry two suitcases, one in each hand, you can walk upright. It's not necessary for you to bend your body either to the left or to the right in this case. Well, these all are the examples of our day-to-day life situations. To understand why people have to bend when carrying an unbalanced load, one has to understand center of gravity. Come on, let us try to understand center of gravity. Have you seen a baseball bat? If not, no worries. Look at the screen in front of you. Now try to balance a baseball bat on one finger. There is only one spot near the thicker end where you can make it balance. If the finger is placed anywhere else along the length of the bat rotates and falls off. Rotation is caused by unbalanced moments. When the finger is in the right place, the moments in the two directions are equal. When the moments in the two directions are equal, the baseball bat balances in horizontal directions. Let us check it out more, how it balances the center of gravity. As you know that every object, such as this baseball bat, is made up of tiny atoms, each being attracted by the pull of the earth. It is being attracted vertically downward because of the earth gravity. In addition to that, each of the atom, I have marked the atom as 1, 2, 3, 4. Only I have considered 4 atoms. You know that matter is made up of innumerable number of atoms, billions of atoms. So each atom produces a moment of force because of its own weight. Atom 1, 2 produces a moment of force W1 and W2 because of its weight in the anticlockwise direction. Atom number 3 and 4, because of its weight, W3 and W4, produces a clockwise moment. Alright? Yeah. Now, look at the illustration on the board. The position at which it supports the bat with force is equal to sum of all the weights of the atom shown by the large arrow. That is, we can see that at this point, the bat balances at the spot, at this particular spot, around which the sum of clockwise moment equals to sum of anticlockwise moment. Okay, and this point around which sum of the clockwise moment and anticlockwise moment balances equally, such that this baseball bat balances on this point. This point I mark it as center of gravity CG. Okay, so center of gravity, at center of gravity I can say that when it is balanced at this point, at this spot, sum of the anticlockwise moment is equal to sum of the clockwise moment. That is, W1 plus W2 is equal to W3 plus W4. Alright? So, when sum of the algebraic sum of clockwise moment and anticlockwise moments are equal, it balances at the spot, that particular spot we call it as center of gravity. So what is center of gravity? Center of gravity CG of a body is the point about which the algebraic sum of the moments of weights of all the particle constituting the body is zero. Okay? So the entire weight, I can say that the entire weight of the body can be considered to act at this point. So the entire weight, I take it as capital W. Okay? Uppercase W. This uppercase W, the weight of the body, the entire weight of the body is supposed to be acting at center of gravity. So remember that the position of center of gravity of a body or a given mass depend on its shape. It can be depending on the shape of the body. Alright? It changes if the body is deformed. For example, center of gravity of a wire. Take a center of gravity of a wire. Just consider a wire, a piece of wire. The center of gravity of a uniform wire is at its middle, at the midpoint. Okay, center of gravity. Alright,
But if the same wire, imagine that is bent into the form of a circle. Now the same wire is bent into the form of a circle. Okay? Then its center of gravity will be then at the center of the circle. Okay? So it will be lying outside the body. Now, so we can say that the position of center of gravity of a body of mass depend on its shape, on the distribution of mass of the particle. It changes if the body is deformed. Alright? This is one example. And also it is not necessary that the center of gravity always be within the material of the body. The center of gravity of a ring or a hollow sphere lies at the center. Center of gravity of a ring. At the center. Center of gravity is at the center. Or it, a hollow sphere. Even a hollow sphere. The center of gravity lies its center. If there is even when there is no material inside, the center of gravity may lie inside the hollow sphere. Alright? Yeah.
Well, all of you like donuts, right? Have you ever thought where is the center of gravity of the donut lying? It's lying at the middle of the donut where there is no donut stuff. There are many more examples in our day-to-day life in which the center of gravity is lying outside. For example, a necklace, boomerang, border, donut, etc. These are the examples where center of gravity lie outside. Now let us consider some regular shaped objects having uniform density. Let us consider the position of center of gravity of these regular shaped bodies. A uniform rod, midpoint of the rod, circular disc, geometric center, sphere, geometric center of the sphere, cylinder, midpoint on the axis of the cylinder, circular ring, center of the ring, rectangular parallelogram, the point of intersection of the diagonals, triangular lamina, the point of intersection of medians, hollow cone at a height h by 3 from the base of on its axis, solid cone at a height h by 4 from the base on its axis, cube or cuboid at the of intersection of diagonals. So please remember these examples of the case of some regular shaped objects. Question can be asked, write an example of some bodies where its center of gravity lies inside the body. Couple of questions for your self-evaluation. Define the term center of gravity of a body. Where is the CG of a uniform ring? Question number 3. Can CG of a body be situated outside its material? Give an example. Question number 4. State a factor on which the position of CG of a body depends. Question number 5. What is the position of CG of a rectangular lamina and cylinder? Now it's recapitulation time. Object balanced at the center of gravity. Weight may be considered to be concentrated at the center of gravity, the entire weight of the body. The center of gravity may be outside the object. Stability of the body depends on center of gravity. So these are the important key concepts of today's topic. Learn these key concepts for learning physics. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks for watching ICSE Physics, keeping intellectually engaged. Thank you very much. Stay tuned for more interesting videos to come up.